And we have talked about Warfield, who has replaced the injured Marty Johnson. Josh Lyman is one of those circus catch type guys. He'll make the big catch. As it'll come to a first down now at the 26-yard line for Utah. Here's Elliott, quick toss, far side. Josh Lyman to the 30, 35. He breaks into the open to the 50. He could go all the way. He's to the 25, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, Utah. Josh Lyman, his third touchdown.
As far as New Mexico is concerned,
great call. Just a quick throw outside, and you can see Paris Jackson and Latondres, the other wide receivers, do a great job of blocking, and Lyman just jumped through the hole, and there's nobody there. It's a foot race all the way to the end zone. That was a great play to isolate those defensive backs of New Mexico.
Well, he was averaging 41 yards receiving a game. In one catch, he has 73, Lyman does. Of course, his twin brother, Jeremy Lyman, one of the starting linebackers or backup linebackers, comes third and fourth. Relentless third start. Near side, ball up, caught. The catch is made, and down the near sideline is Lyman to the 10, to the 5. And what a game Josh Lyman is having. A 73-yard touchdown catch earlier. A big game this time, first and goal at the 6-yard line.
Having a huge game, and it's only the first quarter. You can see they give Elliott time, and Lyman runs the corner route. This is where New Mexico has been hurt all year. The ball downfield, and Lyman does a great job once he gets the ball of making guys miss. But you can see Elliott does a great job of throwing that corner route, and Lyman's out there by himself.
He has over 100 yards receiving now. That was a 53-yard grab to the 6-yard line. Those catches that Josh Lyman might have a pretty good average per catch. Look at that.
63 yards a catch. Hey, Lyman should just shut it down from here and say, no, I'm going to take that from right now and just keep that 63-yard average this game.
Let me tell you, if you're a defensive back, you don't want to see that average.
Oh, because...
Big third down play. Play action. A fake and put it into the end zone. It is caught for the touchdown.
Rice, this is as good as you'll see. At this level, a kid who pumps the ball and gets a DB to bite and has a man wide open because of it, and he succeeds. You know, things work like that. You do it right, you win. You see it. Here comes the pump. Little pump. Now watch how open this guy is. DB got caught looking at something. I wonder what.
Josh Lyman, his second touchdown catch of the year. He's a twin. His twin brother plays linebacker. Utah's on the scoreboard, and it all started with that dropped
game.
7:46 to go in the half. Utah finally makes it onto the board. Arizona leads it 10-7. 7 remain in the third quarter.
Probably why he's a DB and not a wide receiver.
Second and 20. Don't ever say that to him. Rice goes up top, and did he catch it? No. Josh Lyman stretched out. Made a marvel.
Yes, you be the judge. Are we going to go look?
It's not a catch.
He loses it. He does a good acting job. Now watch the official. Oh, we couldn't see it. He comes running in.
If Arizona's defense can do it again, Lance Rice has one in motion. Pump fake goes across the middle. That one is caught. Great catch under pressure by Josh Lyman.
Well, that play was just a matter of who was going to come up with that ball. The DB had a great break on the ball, got there at the same time as the ball, but that wide receiver lineman does a great job of picking this thing out of the air.
Matt Molina almost got a hand on that one, too. Boy, Lyman just took that away from Jolovec.
As I said, they got there together, and he was the one who came up with it. First and it's body.
43 seconds to go. Second down, another pitch. The same area, Lyman's out beyond the line. Incomplete pass. Can you stand it? Just to remind you about Utah's performance on third down tonight, they are 3 of 14, but now they're in four down territory. Here's another look.
Ball's thrown up there. Let's see how he comes down. He's got the ball. That's the touchdown. Well,
wow.
What the refs giveth, the refs taketh away. That's a touchdown. Does a great job of catching that ball and getting the leg down. And we see it, has the ball, knee and leg hit
time
first.
Out in Arizona, second time.
Let's take a look.
Here it is.
Got to have one in. That would be it.
He's got it.
Unless that
unless
knee
his knee's on that line. But we're assuming that his knee hit first.
Jacks up.
I don't play hard.
Well, the pride of Marana right now. And Josh Lyman very much the pride of Salt Lake City.
Well, he had a great game today.
And a possible touchdown catch a moment ago.
Taken away. And, you know, he was open and sometimes not gotten the ball to him.
Third down and 15. Michigan bringing a blitz. Rice has a man. Lyman. With the first down at the 28-yard line. And the Utes come up with a huge conversion here with 6:34 to go in the fourth quarter, a 34-yard pickup.
Anytime on defense, you're going to go ahead and blitz. Here you see them bring the dime back, Cato June, off the corner. You'd better get there. Utah does a great job of maximum protection. Give him Lance Rice time, and he got in behind number 21, Jeremy LaFleur, right there.
With a few yards after the reception.
He was sweating.
They've worked up a pretty good sweat already on a cool evening. There's the play action. Ooh. There's a little screen to throw out to Lyman. Ooh. And Lyman has a Utah first down. Boy, there's some pad popping going on down there.
I love it. Jordan Gross, the right tackle, Steve, that time. He got out there. He just was going full speed. The guy was coming at him again. Then he popped him again. You're going to see Jordan. He's going to come right out to the outside. Watch Jordan Gross. Boom. Kind of misses him, but keep your eye on him. Here we go. Come on. Boom. See ya. Not missing you twice. Super job. And again, these offensive linemen do just a great job of this screen game. Because
and from the shotgun, Rice will go. And he'll look to throw. The pump fake, a little hitch and go. He's got Lyman wide open. They won't catch him. Josh Lyman scores for Utah. They bit big time on the pump.
I think I still have the arm for that one, Steve. And what happened right here is it's just they do a pump right there. You can see it just in the corner of the picture right there where the defensive backs jump the wide receiver coming on that little screen look. And then Josh Lyman, what he does is he goes up, he kind of chatters his feet a little bit, makes like he's going to block the guy on the quick screen, and then him, boom, puts the afterburners on and runs right by him.
Here's a look at the Coca-Cola player card on Josh Lyman out of Salt Lake. And, you know, that little one finger as he pointed to the crowd last night in Provo, that would have got him a 15-yard penalty because that crew last night, if you had the wrong color eyeliner on, it'd have gotten you for celebration. It was unbelievable.
Fortunately for me, I'm not wearing eyeliner like you, but...
Start doing a little hard knocking.
Been knocking on the Jazz door. You want to come back with these guys or anywhere? What do you think about the Jazz?
Definitely want to come back. For the Jazz.
Thanks for your time, big guys. Connect to you guys.
A 34-yard scoring strike from Lance Rice to Josh Lyman with 54 seconds remain just may have undone this man's game plan completely. And as you look at him, has 65 yards, or has six catches, rather, for 111 yards and two touchdowns, and a 34-yarder here.
Well, the DB just got out of position that time. Lance Rice had a little pump fake right there, and I don't know if it was a stutter step on the outside. Most likely it was. He bit on the inside route, and then Lyman runs by for his second touchdown this evening.
And Rice puts the ball right on the numbers.
Right over your head.
Josh Lyman with his big grin on his face. What a great afternoon he's had. And look at the scoring drive.
To throw the football. Second down for the Utes at the 35-yard line of the Aztecs. And again to the air. And again another Utah first down. So the Utes go to Lyman this time and three different receivers. Utah spreading the ball around and they're picking on Ricky Sharp at the cornerback position.
Well, I don't know about you, Steve, but Chris Harris talked to Craig Versteeg before the game. He said things weren't going to change too much. You know what?
They changed
a lot. From my vantage point, they've changed, and they've did a super job. But here it is right there. Great job that time by Josh Lyman, pressing inside, Steve. And what I mean by that, he gets up, he sticks him at the top.
Elliott looks to throw. He's looking for a post pattern, doesn't have a receiver, now goes to the out pattern, and Josh Lyman makes the catch. Boy, that's not much of a spot. Now the official walks up, and he's going to be about 2 yards shy as Jeff Schott was the man they picked on in the other corner. And Utah will drive for the field goal.
Now, Steve, a lot of times you talk to the receivers saying they got to get past the first down marker before they come back. I think Lyman did a good job of that, but the play took so long and Brett Elliott couldn't find him. By the time he got the ball to the outside, he came back. It was a good play, but not enough for the first down.